With an atmosphere of similar density to Earth's, it was believed Titan might even harbor primitive life. To fly past Titan, Voyager 1's Grand Tour would have to be sacrificed. To visit this intriguing moon, it needed to be put on a different path, throwing it up at an angle out of the plane of the solar system. Beyond Titan, there would be no more planetary encounters for Voyager 1. There was one last special task its makers asked of it. Because it was high above the solar system rather than its plane, Voyager 1 had a view of all the planets that its twin could never have. Carl Sagan and Carolyn Porco began discussing an idea.
Voyager was going to be in a location that no other spacecraft had been before, equipped with, you know, sophisticated instrumentation so that it could turn around and take a picture of all the planets in the solar system. And I thought that this would be a riveting collection of images, you know, a first.
So on Valentine's Day, 1990, 13 years after leaving Earth, Voyager 1 was asked to turn its cameras back towards the planets. Now, 3.7 billion miles away, by the time Voyager's pitifully weak signal reached the dishes on Earth, it was just a millionth of a billionth of a watt of power. It was then boosted and sent on to Pasadena, where the image was assembled, here in the Deep Space Control Room. A unique family portrait, the ultimate snapshot of our solar system.
Here is the mosaic
taken. For Carl Sagan, the symbolic value of the photograph was a gift.
The planets move around the sun in any given moment.
He held a press conference to publicize it around the world.
The portrait of the planets has now been taken. And this looks like more than a dot, but it is in fact less than a pixel. In this color picture, you can see that it is slightly blue. And this is where we live, on a blue dot.
With this final historic image captured and nothing more to photograph, Voyager 1's cameras were turned off to save power.